Dr. Susan Looney, the very proud president of Reading Area Community College. And I'm joined here today with Vice President Anthony, aka Tony, DeMarco. He is the Vice President for College Advancement, as well as the Executive Director of the RACC Foundation and the Executive Director for our beautiful Miller Center. Welcome, Tony.
I'm thrilled to be here, Susan. I'm thrilled to talk about all the things that we've done, all the things we're going to do, and about a big party that we have planned on November 10th.
Yes, we do. And I believe that the real goal of today's conversation is really twofold. To celebrate, as you mentioned, a big party coming up to celebrate our 50th anniversary, as well as to educate. Educate the community about all the wonderful things that are occurring at Reading Area Community College.
Celebrate and educate. I love that. I love that it has a nice, and educate is big. We want to educate the community on our history, which is remarkable, mm-hmm. 50 years. We want to educate the community on all the programs that we have, on all the students that we've helped.
It's amazing.
And we want to have a big party.
Yes, we do.
We want to celebrate with all of our community. We're the community's college.
And we're proud of that.
And we are open access to anyone that wants to better their lives and move forward, whether it's academic or a certificate program. We're there for them.
Absolutely. In fact, I talk about access all the time. I talk about the four hallmarks of Reading Area Community College. They are access, opportunity, excellence, and hope. And we provide all four of those hallmarks. Access, we are an open access institution. So as a comprehensive community college, we welcome everyone. Regardless of background, regardless of your educational history, you are welcome at Reading Area Community College. Opportunity, you walk through the doors at RACC and you have an opportunity to change your life. The third is excellence. And we strive for excellence in every single thing we do. And then last, and probably most important, we offer hope. We offer hope to so many students who want to change their lives for the better. And we talk about those four hallmarks all the time at almost at every interaction I get to share that we are, as you mentioned, the community's college.
You know, I think of an alumnus like Mike Doner. Mike Doner, early years, came to RACC when before the Holiday Inn. These are in the early years of our history. And he needed that place. He didn't feel comfortable, a place where he felt comfortable and welcome. He came to RACC, got his degree, and then started building businesses. He's now the CEO of Flagger Force, one of the biggest regional, you know what they do? They're out on the roads, mm-hmm. waving the yeah. flags. And they're in like eight states. He started at Reading Area Community College, one of our many success stories, and talks about that those early days when our great, great leaders, you know, fought the Vietnam. Well, they didn't fight in the Vietnam War, but it was a time of Vietnam. It was the time of opposition. And they came forward and they built a community college.
Mm, that's amazing.
And they, you know, started a tradition that the impact is found with thousands and thousands and thousands of students that have gone on to, you know, whether they're nurses, whether they're CEOs, whether they're teachers, whether they're nurse's aide. It's incredible the impact that we've had at Reading Area Community College.
It is. It's absolutely. And you mentioned just one of thousands of alumni who have graduated from RACC and either started with us and gone anywhere. As you mentioned, maybe a CEO, but students who graduate from RACC can do and become anything they want. Many go right out into the workforce and are getting really well-paying jobs or careers, and others decide that after their 2 years at RACC and graduating, that they want to transfer, and our credits do transfer. Our credits transfer to, in the last 10 years, we did a study not long ago, we noticed that we had students transfer to over 710 four-year institutions across the country. I say that, yet the majority of our students, because they love it here, actually stay in Berks County. They end up staying here in Berks County because they're local, their families are here, and many, the majority of them, the high, I think we were almost in the 90 percentile of our graduates, get a job, live, and pay taxes in Berks County. So I think that's a really important part of being the community's college.
That's what we have to educate right there.
Right.
90 to 95% of our Berks County students, after graduation or attaining that workforce certificate, stay in Berks County. And another education piece is the cost. What's it, 59, 68? I'm trying to remember the exact tuition cost, but it is a tenth of a four-year school. It is affordable, and it is excellent. Our teachers are superb. I've worked at a number of great four-year institutions. I would put our faculty up against any of them.
Our faculty are amazing. And what's also really important to educate is not everyone knows that our class size, the maximum class size at RACC, is 33. So if you come to RACC as a student, the maximum number of colleagues in your class will be only 33, compared to going to a big four-year institution in a lecture hall with potentially 300 other students. It's so easy to get lost. You're not going to get lost at RACC.
You're not a number.
No.
You're not a number at RACC. I love your initiative of taking advising to another level, where you get to know the students. The faculty know the students.
Yes, they do.
We have advisors. They want to make sure they're in the right direction. What we're doing in nursing right now is extraordinary, right?
Yes.
But not everyone is going to be a nurse. And if their academic direction is not for a nurse, maybe it's to phlebotomy, or maybe it's to a lab technician. Maybe it's to, you're the assistant that's in the medical offices that's helping, you know, do that incredible work. Every one of those jobs are essential. And your advising program will take that student and make sure they're on the right career path. But when you talk about nurses, that touches a place in my heart. We're in a pandemic. We're putting wonderfully highly trained nurses into our community, and it's so desperately needed.
We are very well known and very proud of all of our healthcare professions. So you mentioned nursing, but we have a very strong respiratory care program, medical lab assistant, and a certified nursing assistant, phlebotomy with EKG, dental assistant, pharmacy technician. The list just goes on and on and on. So we're really well known for our healthcare programs, but we're also known for workforce training in general. Of course, we have the beautiful Schmidt Training and Technology Center, where manufacturing and healthcare are the top two employers high priority occupations here in Berks County, and we have them both. So we check both of those boxes. We do a lot of training, both for students who are fresh out of high school who want to get into manufacturing, whether it's electrical or machining or
Megatronics,
artificial intelligence, robotics, and we have we have associate programs, but we also have a lot of people from our friends in Berks County, such as East Penn Manufacturing, who send their current employees to RACC to get upskilled. So we really are a mix and mold of a lot of different areas, and we are very proud of all of it. So whether it's getting an associate's degree or getting the skills to go right out into the workforce.
And we have scholarships to cover all those programs. We have so many scholarships, hundreds and hundreds of scholarships, workforce or academic. And, you know, they're going to those students. I see the letters. I see the letters. When they write the letters saying, please consider me for a scholarship, no matter what their situation, we try to help at the foundation. And we have a powerful endowment already.
Yes, we do.
It's growing, and thanks to the gala, it's going to continue to grow. But we're able to help hundreds of students achieve their academic or workforce career dreams. We really work hard at the foundation to match what the wonderful donors of Berks County have created with the student. And when you see these letters, oh, they touch your soul. Mm-hmm. You know, the single mother who has raised her children but wants to now return to the workforce. How many wonderful stories do we have, success stories, that are along those lines? Or the vet who's returning after years of service to our country, and now where can he go to find his next career path? We cover all that, and we find scholarship money for them.
And I believe that the foundation, which is really the board of the foundation, is our volunteers who love the mission of Reading Area Community College. But I believe just last year alone, the foundation gave out almost $1 million in scholarships.
That's correct. These foundation board members take their roles very seriously. They serve, it's unlike any board I've ever seen. We have 2 90-year-olds on our board. They don't ever want to leave. They love what they do. And the sense of giving back and what they feel when they hear the stories, I think it moves them and will continue and grow, you know, into the future. I can't wait to see, you know, what the next 10, 20 years is at RACC. I think more doors are going to open than ever before. We want to, you know, I love the fact that, yes, we are 50%, is it a, what's the terminology?
We are the only Hispanic serving institution in Pennsylvania, and we get that as a federal designation. So the federal government recognizes institutions of higher education once they have 25% or more of their student population self-designated as Latino. And we're very proud of that designation.
Absolutely.
And in fact, we've recently received a Title V grant of $3 million to help us reduce the equity gap between the different genders and populations of our students.
So we have those students coming from downtown Reading or Muhlenberg, and then we have students from every high school in this county.
Absolutely.
We have, I love your presidential scholarships. How great are they? So there's a student, if I get this right, mm-hmm. there's a student in every school in this county that gets a full ride for mm-hmm. 2 years.
Yep, absolutely.
And these students are high GPAs, high SATs, and they want to come to RACC, and then they'll transfer on, and there's already been phenomenal success mm-hmm. stories out of that presidential
Absolutely.
Scholarship. So
Absolutely.
Kudos to you.
Thank you.
For that wonderful, wonderful program, and I'd like to see the foundation jump in and see if we can expand it.
That'd be fabulous.
You know, there are so many students who deserve a college education, and they do. And they here's another one of these fun facts. We don't want them to go into debt. Come to RACC, $5,900. Get those first 2 years. Our credits transfer.
Yes,
there's no reason to go into debt and sign a big loan package at a 4-year. Get your 2-year degree, then go on. Go on to our many friends, both in the county and around the country. But get that 2-year degree at an affordable price. Here's a metric I had no idea. This is a community college national metric. The GPA mm-hmm. of community college students, once they transfer to a 4-year, is higher than those students that started at the 4-year. Did I get that right?
That is exactly right. That is exactly right.
So think about that. Maybe it's because there's a workout. I don't know the reasons mm-hmm. exactly. There's great education at community colleges.
So.
There's a work ethic you see.
Mm-hmm.
There's a determination to succeed. So many are first generation.
Mm-hmm.
That's a number I'd love to see, is how many students are first generation. I know there's a lot.
There are. But yet again, I mean, we as an open access institution, and because we welcome all students, we are such a diverse campus. It's beautiful when you walk on campus to see the diversity of our student population and the levels of them coming into the front doors. I mentioned that we welcome everybody, but I think there's an assumption that, well, you couldn't go to a 4-year school, so you went to RACC, and that is an incorrect assumption. Some of our students walk in and enter right into our amazing honors program or join Phi Theta Kappa, which is the International Honor Society for 2-year colleges. Those students are top-notch, 3.5 GPA or above, and we have one of the top Phi Theta Kappa chapters in the country. We make the top 100 list year after year after year due to the amazing service work that the students do and because they're great advisors.
Celebrate.
Celebrate. Let's talk about a celebration.
Well, I want to celebrate those students, and we're going to do that. We're going to, on November 10th, we're going to celebrate all those stories, all those student stories that have meant so much to Berks County, that have meant so much to the area industries. We're going to celebrate our history. I've been blown away in my short 15 months at RACC by the leadership that we've had over 50 years.
It's amazing.
That started with Dr. Byron Reinheimer back in 1971. You have three predecessors that are extraordinary people that we will talk about, and they'll all be part of the celebration. Dr. Gus Sogas, who brought the sponsorship of the college from the Reading School District to the county. It's a, an idea or concept that was huge at the time, and the county has embraced.
Yes, Senator. Wonderful.
The county commissioners have embraced RACC. It's a tremendous partnership, and it was Gus that led the efforts with a number of volunteers, led by the great Rolf Schmidt, to make that transition. Dick Kratz, what a wonderful, warm leader he is, who had a tremendous impact on the school. And then Dr. Anna, who your predecessor. So we're going to celebrate them and all the great work that they did, and celebrate the growth. How many students did we start with?
235?
Yeah, I mean, it was a small number back in 1971. Right now, where are we?
Close to 8,000.
8,000. We're the biggest school in Berks County.
We are.
We're the biggest school in Berks County.
We are.
8,000 students. Think about that. Come through our doors over the course of a year. And, they're a testament to all this history, where we've grown and how we achieve that. So we'll celebrate the presidents. We'll celebrate some of the great leaders in our history. We're going to bestow honorary director status on six legendary Berks County philanthropists who served our foundation board. We're going to celebrate Dick East, Brian Hard, Chris Pruitt, Mike Ellerman, Nora Sabatka, and the great John Weidenhammer. And John's going to lead us with a toast.
Yes, the champagne toast of
the
evening.
John is going to lead us with a toast on November 10th as we celebrate 50 years. So we're going to honor them. We're going to have a wonderful student who is a Reading High School graduate who's on the way to great things. Mm-hmm. We're going to have a very successful alum make a brief talk on her successes. We're going to welcome our friends from the mayor's office, state senator, and the county commissioners to all put a couple words together on what RACC means. And then we have a keynote speaker that it's extraordinary that we're getting one of the great entrepreneurs in, this is going to sound crazy, in world history.
Mm-hmm. I would agree.
This is world history. How many of us have an apple in our pockets? I got one.
Almost everybody.
The co-founder of Apple is coming to Reading. Steve the Woz Wozniak is coming to our gala as our keynote speaker. And we had a conversation with him just yesterday as we talked about the night. He loves community colleges.
He does.
He loves education. And he's going to share his experience. I was blown away yesterday. I knew he went to De Anza Community College. He initially went to Boulder, had some issues, then went to De Anza for a couple of years. And he took all sorts of things, not just computer. And then he went to Berkeley, founded Apple, and the rest is history, although he continues to take courses at community college to just better himself. But the Woz is one of those unbelievable leaders visionaries who sees things before others. The old blue box with a keyboard, he's the one who put it together. When you think of the Apple I, the Apple II, that was all Steve Wozniak. To have him as our keynote speaker is just a magical confluence of things that came together. I'll tell that. So Rolf Schmidt is one of our great philanthropists.
Yes, he is. Wonderful man.
He's established the Speakers Endowment. But he gave us a set of criteria for the gala. I said, Rolf, this is big. We need to, focus that endowment on a really special guy. And he's like, Tony, no politicians, no athletes, no entertainers. I want someone that went to a community college and is in tech. Okay, Rolf. That narrows it down. But then through the guy who's helping us, get the great acts at the Miller Center, said, I have an idea. Let me reach out to the Woz. And he said, yes. He said, yes. And then yesterday we had a conversation as if he was our best friend.
Amazing man. Lifelong learner.
Right.
Loves to learn. Wants to continue still to go to a community college and take all types of classes.
Yeah, he wants to, study everything. He's 71 years old. So he's also going to, I've got the IWOS. I don't know if... you got this book, but we're going to have a ton of copies that are autographed, and then we'll put them up for auction, or we'll determine how to direct the funds for people to buy an autographed copy of IWOS, and those funds will go into scholarship support, which is very close to his heart. So
for anyone who's watching, is there still time to get tickets?
There
for
are
the gala?
Tickets available. It's
okay,
going to be
it's getting close.
Yeah, there's not a lot. We're not quite sold out, but we're knocking on the door. We're somewhere around 750.
Wow.
The DoubleTree holds
880.
Something like 880. So, if you want your tickets, go online. And you'll see it. It's on our website. We have a special 50th link. Go click on the button. You can buy them right there. And you want to be part of this night. I mean, this is going to be one of the great nights in Berks County history. This is going to be a night that, people will remember forever. So you want to be there. And it's a night with one of the real legends of today's world with us. So please go online there are still some sponsorship opportunities as well.
Okay.
So reach out to me, Tony DeMarco, ADeMarco@RACC.edu.
Correct.
And I can help you with tickets. I can help you with sponsorships. But move quickly, because it won't be long before those tickets are sold out. I think we're heading to a sellout.
That's amazing. I believe most of the funds are going towards student scholarships.
Yeah, there's three initiatives. Three initiatives that resonate, that are so important. One of them is workforce
critical
scholarships.
Critical.
These are the certificate programs that go right to work. Right now, nurses' aides, if you can go through, and I don't think it's a long program.
No, it's not at all.
What's it, like 10 weeks, 12 weeks, something like that. If you take our nurses' aides program, you can get a job, whether it's the Highlands or any of the senior care. They're offering bonuses, big bonus.
They
heard $10,000. So just get through those 10 weeks. So there's going to be scholarship support for workforce. Mm-hmm. And then this is one of the great scholarship programs you'll ever know. 15 years ago, some of the great leaders in history, Marlon Miller and John Broadbent and Jim Connors, Ray Nieag, got together and they established the Reading High School to RACC Opportunity Scholarships to give deserving students who have nothing a chance at a college education. We want to expand this program. There's so many students in Reading High that want a college education. Let's give them that. So that is one of the big initiatives. Mm-hmm. So workforce, the Reading High to RACC, and then emerging needs, which is for you, as you see are so many important priorities, you'll be able to direct funds to whatever is the highest priority. So these are initiatives that are resonating in the community. we're going to raise a lot of money, Susan.
It's going to be a big night.
Yeah, we're going to raise a lot of money. And then we'll look to the future.
And we have a very bright future.
Oh, my God.
It's only been 50 years. I can only imagine the amazing things we are going to continue to do, the great education, the number of students that we can transform their lives for the better. Just us being the community's college, being here, being focused on student success, and being a proactive community partner. We're just, I know I'm personally very honored to be the president of Reading Area Community College at this special time.
There's initiatives that we can't share yet. Big initiatives that are coming. And when they happen, oh my God. The future is so bright. Yeah. The future is so bright at RACC. And like you, it touches my heart to be, I always thought that I'd eventually be in an essential nonprofit organization. Reading Area Community College is as essential as any organization, you know, in our region. We are lifting our community.
Yes, we are.
Our students are staying here. I reflect often about 20 and 30 years, you know, the scholarships we're generating. I may not be around,
right,
but I know that wherever I am, I'll look down and I'll see these successful people that are lifting our community up because of the work that you're doing, the work that our foundation's doing, that our faculty's doing, and all of our partners. It gives me goosebumps to think of the impact that we're having.
And it's amazing, and I feel so humbled to be able to hopefully have a positive impact on the lives of students, and in some cases on people we will never know.
Right.
Talk about leaving a legacy and changing the landscape of our community for the better. It's wonderful. And Tony, it has been such a wonderful opportunity today and a real honor to talk to you today.
It's fun. I love sharing our story.
I do too.
I love talking about the things that have happened, the things that are going to happen, and talking about the party of 50 years. Is it the golden? Is that 50? The golden? I think that's what I think it's the golden anniversary of RACC. And it does. It feels golden. It feels
special.
Really special. So many people have expressed support for this milestone. Mm-hmm. And I can't wait for November 10th.
Well, I hope everyone watching can join us. And if not attend, maybe just support us.
That's right. If you can't make it, there's a place to click. You can help us or just give me a ring. All my contact information's out there.
Yep.
Call me or email me and let's help the next generation of students.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Tony. It's been great.
Yay.
Thank you all for watching.